Joyce on Sun. We have Jet, Stryker, Gus, and Turk, who are joined by their trainers, Ashley and Reagan. We want to start our presentation today by giving you an up-close look at some of the incredible features of our dolphins. Atlantic bottlenose dolphins, like Jet, Stryker, and Turk here, have between 72 and 104 cone-shaped teeth. They use these teeth for catching and grabbing fish, as well as interacting with their environment. Next, we're going to turn down the music, and we ask that the entire audience is as silent as possible. We are going to be listening to the animals exhale from their blowhole. Dolphins breathe only from that blowhole on top of their head and not out of their mouth. They also use their blowhole to make a variety of different vocalizations. Dolphins have amazing eyesight and can see just as well below the surface of the water as they can above the surface of the water. Right behind their eyes are tiny pinholes. These pinholes are the dolphin's ears. Dolphin ears are internal to help with their streamlined body shape. Next, we're going to move on to the dolphin's pectoral flippers. These flippers help them steer as they move through the water, and they also have bones inside them. The fin on their back is known as the dorsal fin, and it helps to stabilize them as they move through the water at speeds up to 20 miles per hour. Dolphins are mammals, which means they give birth to live young. Therefore, dolphins have belly buttons. Please draw your attention to the acrylic windows and look at the stomachs of our animals. There is a small indentation on the center, and that is their belly button. Last, we want you to check out our dolphins' tails, also known as flukes. Each fluke is unique to the animal, similar to how a fingerprint is for a person. No two dolphins have the same shape or size flukes. Now how about we see those flukes in motion by demonstrating their impressive speed. If you're on the left-hand side of the stadium, you will be cheering for Gus and Turk. So let's hear it out there for Gus and Turk. Now if you're on the right-hand side of the stadium, you will be cheering for Jet and Stryker. Let's hear it out there for Jet and Stryker. All right, boys, on your mark, get set, go.
Is my queen, don't she stay strong? Yeah, she is always in my corner, right there when I wanna. All these other girls are tempting, but I'm empty.
All right, Jet and Stryker, you're up next.
Do you need me? Do you think I'm a dad?
Nice job, boys. But it looks like Jet and Stryker barely won by a nose. Well, in this case, you would say rostrum, as dolphins don't have noses. As part of their daily care, we make sure they are mentally stimulated by offering a variety of toys, or what we call environmental enrichment devices, to stimulate their different senses. They use various parts of their body, including that rostrum or mouth area, to explore these objects. Surf's up, flipper friends, I know you're ready to catch the biggest wave.
Somebody call 911.
We're just out here enjoying the sun and having a good time while you stroll up throwing trash into their home. Trash and marine debris are major problems in our oceans because plastic bottles can take up to 1,000 years to decompose. How about we show you a better way to deal with your plastic bottles? Way to go, Turk! Alright, beachgoer, do you think you can keep it clean during your visit here? Appreciate littering. Dolphins, why don't you tell us what you think about pollution? Did you learn your lesson? As you can see, it's really important to help keep the environment clean. The unfortunate reality is that you may encounter a stranded animal due to marine debris at some point. If you do, make sure you set up a perimeter to keep people away from the animal and keep the animal wet with towels and water. One of our trainers is going to demonstrate how to do this in case you ever find yourself in these situations. It is especially important to make sure you contact your local marine mammal rescue. Here we have the Gulf World Marine Institute. The Gulf World Marine Institute has rescued more than 4,000 sea turtles. We are home to more than 10 rescued animals. Can we count on everyone in our audience to help animals in our oceans by keeping them clean? You're a bigger crowd than that. I can't hear you. Can we count on everyone? That is great to hear. Because at Gulf World, we strongly believe that future generations have a purpose. Or should we say, porpoise, by being the key to saving the environment. After all, dolphins do need vitamin C to stay healthy. Doing simple things like reducing our use of single-use plastics, such as straws and plastic bags, can make a huge difference. That is why it is so important to educate our guests and allow them to make connections with the animals we love. Now at this time, you saw that we just said goodbye to Jet, Striker, Gus, and Turk. But don't worry, we're about to welcome out two more of our dolphins. Now these two are two special ladies here at Dolphin Stadium. Their name is Sandy and Capri. So ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for Sandy and Capri. As you can see, we love spending time with our animals. Our trainers are here on weekends, holidays, and we are even here for them 365 days a year. We would love to show you the opportunity and how special this relationship is with these amazing animals.
I love the way I get to call you mine.
Seasons change, I'll be the soul.
to say goodbye to our Clipper friends. But before we let you go, let's give them one last round of applause. Thank you all so much for coming to spend time with us here at Ball Club. We hope to spend your time with Sandy, Capri, Jet Striker, Gus and Turk, along with their trainers, Ashley, Christina, and Reagan, has inspired you to make our oceans a safer place for all marine life. We hope to see you again soon, and we hope you enjoy the rest of your day right here at Golf World.